Everyone, Dave, Display Fireworks One. We're here in Branson, Missouri for the National Fireworks Association Convention 2019. You'll have to forgive my voice a little bit. I have a little bit of laryngitis. That's just how it goes. But we're going to go down and tour the floor a little bit. I'll share some of the experience with you. This is where all the people in the business meet, and it's a trade show. Man, this is a great shot of it right here. Good look. Can pan through. You'll recognize some of the names in the business. So it's a fun time for me because a lot of people follow my videos. Some are here from other countries, China. I met a guy from El Salvador, and I'm sure that's going to continue as we go through. So I'll share some of it with you, and thanks for following. Here at Spirit of 76, and I know a lot of you follow my videos with the Cobra, different systems. I'm using some of these articles of pyrotechnics. Here, let's come around, I'll show you some. That white cap on it. Yes. There's a. Then you put it in slide it in here. It would slide over to here. Put the white cap on it. And here, these fit in different angles. For you guys that like to do the pyro musicals, different effects.
I don't think anybody's an expert anymore. You can always learn something, right? Yeah. Well, exactly. I definitely heard you guys.
That's it. Figure we'd show you that as we went around. We're going around at the NFA. This is Eric. And he has something that's actually kind of cool and kind of needed. Here, let me grab one here. It's a dog treat for
traveling, thunderstorms, fireworks, going to the vet, separation anxiety, specifically fireworks at NFA. It's an all-natural peanut butter brownie that has a couple calming ingredients. The dosing depends on the size of your dog, but a little bit will do the trick. Your dog will be calm for the duration of the night and won't run away and won't chew up your furniture.
It's always a problem with dogs. You know, when you live in a neighborhood, if you get a complaint, it's usually from someone with a dog.
Absolutely.
So he's recommending if you have a fireworks stand or store, you put these up at the counter and sell them, and they seem to work, you said.
Yeah, we have 5 stores, and we've been selling them for 5 years, been selling great. A lot of people have been helped out by them.
All right, so there it is. It's called
Heavenly Hounds.
Heavenly Hounds, the original.
There you go.
All right, Eric, thank you, buddy.
Thank you.
Take care. One day, I'm going around at the NFA. I'm here with Pete from Shogun and some of their products. And he has a couple interesting things he's going to show us with his special flame machine.
Yeah, so I think you remember from last year we did our flame machines. The G Flames, they've been super popular for us. And in the last 18 months or so, we've sold quite a bit of them. If you haven't yet heard of G Flames from Galaxis, I'm sure you will. We're working with Cobra on having some control things built in so that you'll be able to use a Cobra firing system to control G-Flames, which is going to be fantastic. That's going to open it up quite a bit for us. But yeah, if you're looking to get into flames, please look us up. You can contact us, go on the website, you'll get all the info there. I'm sure you'll pop it up on the video there.
Sure, I'll have it in the description.
Perfect. Also, we're excited to do a couple new things with our single shots. Last year and this year, we have our no debris stuff. So you'll notice these are actually plastic tubes. These are designed to be used in a proximate environment, not necessarily an indoor environment, because they aren't rated for height or anything like that. But okay, if you're shooting in a stadium and you can't leave any debris behind, these are absolutely perfect for that. So we have customers using these in stadiums around the world now. The nice thing is they have a plastic tube, makes them weather resistant. We have them available in a 30 and a 40 millimeter single shot. We also have them available in a multi-shot plate. So you light one igniter there, and then you have a couple second delay between shots. So this is very commonly whenever you see like NFL games on TV and stuff.
Yeah.
Usually this is the type of product that you're seeing. We're able to bring it in through us at an extremely good price point. It's available currently from Casabella Pyrotechnics in Southern Indiana.
Yeah.
And then we have a bunch more coming to the United States.
Great.
We're also very excited. We're also very excited to be working with Minetti Fireworks. They are a manufacturer of products from Italy.
Oh,
they've come up with a brand new system of shooting single shots. So we all know the thing that takes the most amount of work, taking each one of these tubes, running an e-match to it, and plugging it in. Any good-sized display nowadays will have hundreds, if not thousands, of these tubes, thousands of connections.
Sure.
So what they've done is they've created these bases. These are intended to mount to whatever single shot system you already have. We put them on the Pyrolama systems or on the slider system, but you can also simply strap them to a piece of wood. You can mount them to a single shot rack that you already have on whatever angles you want. The idea is you attach these once, you wire these once into your firing system, and then the next time you go to shoot, instead of putting in a wire, running it back, and plugging it in, you order the single shots, which we have available from us, the Vulcan Shogun single shots. This is called the iShot system. Instead of having a normal plug with an e-match receptacle, they come with this specialty plug, okay? This comes from the factory this way, you order from us. What you do is, instead of having a wire sticking out of here, it's a little igniter that has a tab on it. You break the tab off, there's absolutely no wires or anything. Since this is already pre-wired into your firing system, literally to shoot it, you simply plug it in and it's ready to shoot.
Wow.
So we were able to set up, we did a little demo of these at PGI this year, a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
We were able to shoot, there was like 350 or so of these. Once we started plugging them in, it took us about 30 minutes to get the whole thing ready. So it's absolute game changer. It's about a 10x time saver. The bases we have available in the United States, I have a limited supply now, but we have more coming.
Yeah.
We need some. But the eye shots, they're available to order from Vulcan and Shogun, as well as from Casabella.
Casabella will have them.
Other importers as well,
Let's take a little closer look at this.
Yeah.
This is great.
So the whole idea is you wire them once the way you want to.
Put your mats.
Minetti
your
also
bars.
Makes a rack that's fully adjustable. So every single one of these can be adjusted on its own angle.
Yeah.
So when you actually set up your show, you literally...
Oh, yeah, you could turn it.
Plug this in, and then you just adjust the angle, and you're done. You're ready to shoot.
That is something.
Huge time saver. Oh, that's just the sample plug coming out there.
Oh, there it is.
To remove it, there's a little button here. Push that right out. It's weather resistant. We actually had these. You see there's a little bit of dirt and mud on this. This was actually used at PGI.
Mm-hmm.
That freak hailstorm that came in on Wednesday night. These were absolutely flooded, and they were fine. No problem.
Right. So, just a little adjustment here.
Yeah, in the tradition of Vulcan being kind of cutting edge, trying to do the leading innovative stuff in the business, as soon as we saw iShots available from Minetti, we partnered with them right away, wanted to make the stuff available. So yeah,
very nice.
Really, really cool.
All right, now we're going to move over to the consumer product. Still with Pete, we moved over just a little bit. We're in the consumer section. Tell us what we got, Pete.
So this is our 2020 lineup of new items from Shogun Fireworks, which is our consumer label. We've got a lot of really, really good effects. We work really hard, not just on making really cool fireworks or making really cheap fireworks. The important thing is to have a price point that works, a package that works, and a performance that works very, very well for our customers, which we keep in mind from the moment we start making the products. So we've got some new items here. The triple play is a really cool effect. You have three different angles during your effects, during your shots. So you got comets on the outside, you got really nice breaks on the inside with an awesome finale. Split shot is actually kind of a waterfall effect. It comes out of both sides, sort of a bow tie. Howler Monkey is actually super unique. This is a whistling effect that actually fires up, bursts in the sky, and then the whistles come up out of there. So you're getting an elevated kind of whistle thing, which is kind of unique, new for this year. Are absolutely awesome is your Nishiki Kimura effect. The 24K Magic is the massive gold brocade. Really, really nice. The wheel in the sky is a beautiful ring with pistol. We're super proud of our new American Pride canister shells, a 5-inch. Really nice packaging on that one. Really patriotic. It's going to look great on a shelf, we think. Our Thriller here is a Z-Cake that we came out with for this year. Super cool, great effects, very, very good value for a Z-Cake. 3-Minute Mayhem, this is actually a 3-minute long cake. One fuse, nice. 3 minutes of fireworks. You got straight up shots, you have angled shots, you have a nice finale to it. And it's actually decent. It's not just filler, comets and stuff.
Yeah.
You can see by the tube sizes, you're getting decent breaks. The pace is good. There's not any long lags or anything like that. It's actually a really, really, really
this
great
value.
This
would be good if you had a Cobra and put two together. Fire both at the same time.
Absolutely.
And just sit back and enjoy it.
Or if you're a retailer and you have this sitting on your shelf, you can imagine how many of these you're going to sell for the families
just
that want
that.
To light one fuse and just have an easy show. I mean, that's going to be fantastic. Our double action here, really nice cake. Double breaks every shot. It's a 9-shot, massive breaks with really nice crackle finish. The second shot on every single one of these is a huge crackle burst. And then the final shot is a double crackle burst. I know crackle's a little overrated. I'm sure your audience is a little sick of crackle.
They want to end everything with crackle.
I believe, though, if you do it right, it's really nice.
Yeah.
This is that large kind of popcorn crackle that comes in after and really fills the sky.
Yeah.
You know, so that's a little more unique.
I like a time rain effect, too.
Right.
Kind of a crackle.
Yeah, exactly. Moving on down over here, we have some of our smaller items. For this year, we have a couple 350-gram or value 500-gram, however you want to call it, Crown Jewels, America First, and our Sizzler. These are all single effect, so for guys that are shooting shows, this is going to be perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Crown Jewels is a very nice palm with color tips. America First is a nice red, white, and blue effect. And Sizzler is a crackling palm with color tips. Super nice. One thing I'm super excited about is this 8-shot Big Burst rack. It's a 200-gram cake. We designed it actually to look like a rack. The orange is supposed to be like a fiberglass sort of tube.
Yeah.
And then you've got like kind of a wood finish. The brakes on this are absolutely huge. This one is going to shock everybody once they see it.
Here's your double.
Here's our Bang Bang 6-inch double break shells. So it's a canister shell with two breaks.
These
are true canisters. These are not fake ball shells in there. It's a double canister, really nice and snappy, nice big breaks. This 24 turbocharged is actually miniature canister shells. They're 1.5-inch size. So for those of you that are looking for a little bit better value, you can walk out of the store with one of these. You still get really nice snaps to them, really nice lifts to them, great bursts, great colors, but it brings the price point down just a little bit, but just as much fun as a regular canister shell. We came out with our boy, girl, gender reveal stuff. I know this has kind of been a popular theme for a few years, but we thought we'd do a little unique spin on it. This is actually a fountain. It'll actually do a blue or a red flare for boy or girl with a silver fountain, as well as a strobe inside here. Once the strobe starts going off, this film will actually light up with either the boy or the girl logo. Kind of adds a little bit of action, and it's nice and quiet. There's no noise to this. You want to shoot it in your backyard, you're not going to bother the neighbors.
That's a good feature.
Very, very, very nice and quiet. Just a quiet silver fountain with a flare and a nice gentle strobe. You can do this at any backyard barbecue, any family get-together.
I like quiet fountains sometimes.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes. And in fact, the silver is a nice low smoke as well, so you're not going to bother anybody with that.
Piggyback. Right?
Pigs can fly. This is our triple spinner, aerial spinner. So you light one fuse, you get a little spinner, a slightly bigger spinner, and then finally your larger spinner with a little crackle finish. So it's a little, you know, adds a little bit of fun. You light one fuse, you get a little mini show for the kids, you know?
Very good. Well, what else we got? The bat.
We're excited for our home run. This is actually just a simple handheld item. It does a red to blue flare on here. Great for our safe and sane customers, our customers in safe and sane states. We can have a little bit of fun, pretty safe. There's not huge spray or anything like that. It's gonna be really contained for you. And the whole home run packaging kind of brings a little bit of summer fun to it, I think.
All right, Pete, thank you very much. And I'm still moving around here at the NFA.
Thank you.
Everyone, it's Dave, still making my way around the NFA. Look what is, by the time you see it, it'll be official. CobraCon 2020, Lawrenceburg, Indiana. Here's the dates. And here's the website for more information. And while we're also here, we're going to look at the Cobra. One of your favorite YouTubers is here, Joel Robinson. Hey, Joel.
Hey, how's it going?
All right, buddy. You're working for Cobra, and I asked him to showcase a couple items, and he picked this to show us. So let's come on up and let Joel explain it.
Yeah, so these are our newest item. We call these quick plugs. So the quick plugs are specifically these ports here. These are custom designed ports. And I do not have the match to show you how it plugs in, but basically your existing E-match and Talons have a little connector on the end. Those can be installed right here onto this port, either direction, so you can plug it in either which way. The whole point is it's a lot quicker and easier to set up versus the traditional speaker terminals, and also a lot quicker in teardown.
Sure.
And then also the profile of these is a lot smaller. So this is our 72Q module, and you'll see we have 72 here, as well as all the connectors if you want to use slats. And if you come look over here, this is our 18M, and this has been retrofitted into using quick plugs. So if you already have an 18M, you can buy these Q-strips and upgrade your existing unit. Also with this upgrade, it has a support for a 6Q slat. So this is an RJ45 connector, and then we have these new quick plug slats as well. And then the last guy here, this is our 36Q module, and you'll see, again, with the size profile, it's the same size profile as the 18M, but we were able to fit all 36 onto this profile.
Wow.
And there's a few other options as well, I just don't have them here.
So this cable can be as long as you want, really.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, you could have this up somewhere.
And you can chain them, too.
Wow.
So basically, this is taking an 18Q module, and then you can break it out into multiple positions from just one module.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and you could daisy chain, keep
exactly.
It going.
Yep.
And this has been out. This is.
Yeah, I think you looked at this before. This is the command center.
Okay. So this is basically what's new.
Yeah. Yeah, this is still not technically officially released, but there are some units out in the field today.
All right, let's take a little closer look at this.
Yeah, but I think if you
don't... Yeah, so it has the ATR2 built into the unit here.
Mm-hmm.
The signal amplifying booster. Both of these are being run by an internal LiPo battery. The charge port's on the side here. Battery indicator's right here, so you can see exactly what's going on. And then the tablet's built into the case. This does move. If you're sitting down, you can lower it. If you're standing up, you can raise it.
Nice.
This is also a very quick release action. So if you need to replace the tablet or take it out to use it for some other function. On the side here, we have our USB port for loading a script or reprogramming the unit. There's the dead man port and also time code. And then here in the middle, this is just a notepad. So if you have any notes about the show, you can write them here with dry erase marker. And then on the inside here is a storage compartment. So you can store the charger, dead man, trigger, your antenna, whatever you need.
This is great.
That's pretty much the whole unit.
This is wireless.
Yeah, where's the charge ports here?
Yep, charge is over here. And so also one of the cool things is if the internal battery is dead, you can actually plug the charger in and it'll run the ATR2 and the booster. So if you accidentally didn't charge it, you can still use the system.
Fire a generator up or something.
Okay.
All right, everyone, there it is. That's what's new from Cobra, making my way around. We're still here at the NFA convention. We're seeing some upgrades on the Firefly system. And I'm here with Kevin, the owner of the company, and he's going to show us. Here's the two right here. See the glow? Okay, now we had that before, but guess what? Now you can put an electric match in it. If you look real close, you'll see two little slits there in the rubber. The electric match comes in, it touches either one of those, and you can close this. And the wires come out here. Right?
Yep.
It'll work with what, a regular electric match?
Regular MJGs? MJGs will work as well. We can fit up to 7 E-matches at once.
Okay.
Or 3 to 4 Talons, mm-hmm. right? The new clips, you can also remove them, which has been a big ask from our customers, to be able to remove these clips in case they break.
Yeah.
But as you can tell from these ones here, we've been using them quite a bit.
Yeah.
They have not been degrading because we anodize our metals now, which has been a big issue for us too. Our new systems also use Wi-Fi instead of Bluetooth. We've learned a lesson there. Bluetooth gives you a range of 30 to 50 feet. No matter what you do, it's going to be 30 to 50 feet, right? But with Wi-Fi, you've got about 350 feet away.
Oh, you can get nice,
You can get a really good distance away.
Yeah.
Because we're using Wi-Fi mesh systems, what's going to happen now is each system will talk to each other and extend that range even further.
That's it.
So we've done every single thing that we've learned from the first generation of Firefly, guarantee you guys. It's all in here. Everything. Power stability, everything that people have had issues with.
Yeah.
I've listened, and we've delivered this new system. Because we also have the 15Q, as well as a smaller 5Q system now. Just to kind of get everybody to get into the firing.
Mm-hmm.
So, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we wanted to give Kevin a chance to show us what he has improved on. I think the addition of the electric matches are good, you know, because now you can buy the MJG initiators and start acting like the pros with the system. All right, Kevin, thank you.
Thank you,
best of luck. Okay, still here at the NFA. Get a little shot of some of the Dominator products. These are all what they call dummy samples. Bring them in for the convention. This box here. We'll take a look at some of the articles of pyrotechnic stuff. There's Dominator articles of pyro stuff.
Those right there are smaller.
See, here's what you want to look at right here. See, that'll unplug. And you can plug your electric match in there. Connect it to quick match. And you'll get your effect right here. And we're playing a show with some of their props. Once you know what you're doing, you put some hell of an effect on. And the corresponding number underneath. One day of display fireworks while we're still here at the NFA. I'm here with Carson Lee.
Hello guys, I'm Carson Lee with Boom Wild Fireworks.
Boom Wild Fireworks. And here's his little booth area.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to take a look at what he has. He's new, mostly new to the United States, I think. And you want to get your product out there and distributors and this kind of thing.
Yeah, that's so right.
Let's take a look at some of the stuff.
Yeah.
And this is what, 500 gram?
Yeah, 500, 3-inch nine shawl. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And those are the little 200 gram cake. It comes in a box.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's kind of like...
Oh, like we have family, three different ones.
Yes, that's right.
Pull it out. These are all demo samples, so everyone knows.
Yeah,
here.
That's right.
This is, I always like this kind of thing.
Fish the fishes.
Fish effect.
Yeah. They are all carnival fishes.
Yeah.
Basically.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And what we have down here?
We've got here like Midwest Storm, that's a good one, and also the Warning.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got here some little fountains. You know, those are 200 gram fountain. If you look on our website,
yeah,
they are super. People love it. You know, the effects are incredible. And we've got 500 gram fountain.
Yep.
We've got double breaks.
Mm-hmm.
And here we've got the red, white, blue thing for
yep.
controlled it.
Yep.
We've got a complete gender reveal solution.
Yeah, this goes in the box, everyone knows. And this is a fountain.
Yeah, it's a fountain.
Comes out here.
Yeah. But comes out from here. Three fountains and a massive effect.
Yeah,
that's right.
This one you had last year, I think.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah. Are you making fun of our president? There's a few like this out there, which are which are all humor, you know.
Okay.
Fun.
Okay.
And nine on the board.
Yeah, and we've got popular canisters. You guys can check it out, and they are super good rates and effects.
Yeah.
That's a big set of them.
This is canister and this?
Both of them.
Uh-huh.
Those are 12.6 to the 24s.
Uh-huh. Yeah. This is a popular canister.
Yes. And we've got here a collection of new products, novelties items. And those the cannibal rush thing, which is very good. You guys can check it out. And that's a fountain.
Yeah, I like the labeling. It's nice.
And
colorful.
Those are the new thing.
This thing spins, huh?
And you know that.
Very nice. Something for the kids they like, huh?
And also that's also different, the triangle
cannibal. Yeah. And let's move over this way.
Okay.
We've
got a complete solution for party line as well.
Confetti,
yes. And also baseballs, sky lanterns, streamers, everything. Balloons.
And what's this?
This one?
Yeah.
That's a very typical item that we made. It's canisters inside of it.
Oh, okay.
Canisters inside of it, and it's super brave. People can use it for front door decoration.
Yeah.
Or kids
have it in their room.
Yeah, in the room for
something
decoration.
Something like that.
Yeah, that's
now,
right.
I saw you had something that you threw.
Yeah.
And I'm going to stop for a minute. Maybe you show that to us.
Okay.
All right. We're going to come right back. Okay. This is it's somehow you hold it and then you grow it, but first you have to peel it off. So tell me.
You put your finger in there to hold it.
You can. Yeah. You will just peel off.
Peel it open.
Yeah. And then you put your finger here in the crane and then you throw.
Okay.
Make sure you keep that on your finger so those go flying out.
Yeah, that's right.
I think I got it.
Okay.
All right, ready?
Okay.
I'm going to throw it over
here. Yeah, that way.
Look at the size of that thing. Now, here's the best part. It's, as always, roll it up.
It was just easy to bring it up.
So,
all that came from one.
There it is right there. Kind of reminds me of the one of my other advertisers has with the pull string.
Yeah.
But this one you just hand from.
Yeah. Different experience.
It's very nice, yeah.
Thank you.
There it is, boomwah. A little bit of everything. Hope you enjoyed it. We're still at the convention, moving over to Intergalactic. Cairo. Let's take a look. Some of their products. They're big on the zombies. I don't know if that's an alien. You know, don't their belly buttons go a different way or something?
Yeah.
mushrooms or something, huh? Kind of cool. All right, just paying a little visit and checking them out. Everyone, it's Dave. Display Fireworks One. I'm here at the NFA convention going around. One of my advertisers, American Fireworks. This is Sabrina, one of the representatives from the company. She's going to tell us a little bit about American Fireworks. Well, I can say one thing, that they sell the articles of pyrotechnics that I have a certification for. And Sabrina was saying when people come in, you kind of guide them towards that.
In order to buy the articles of pyrotechnics from us, we require that you have some type of certificate. Dave's certificate is ideal for us.
There it is. So if you have a Cobra or whatever, you can look how all that works. But now, in addition to doing displays and hiring people for next year, because 4th of July is on a Saturday, we talked about that a little bit. We say, you know, they have classes, and I think the best pool of people to get is from people to watch my videos.
Yes, very much.
Tell us about your new brand of product you have. Here's on this sign, you have a consumer product?
So we just came out with Heavyweight brand. We're currently up to 9 cases, 9 different types of. We've got our canister shells, our 500 grams, we've got our 200 grams. So Heavyweight is definitely going to be the next up and coming brand for you. Definitely is worth checking out.
Here it is here. And in addition to that, tell them about the brands on the other one here.
So we're a wholesaler and we carry 25 different brands. So we are a one-stop shop. You can get all these different brands with us from our sales, from our store. You just pop on our website, American Wholesale Fireworks, and you put in your order and we ship it straight out to you.
Okay, they're located in Hudson, Ohio. And she's, when she goes back, she's going to check if they have my cake, Academic Pyro. And if they do, we'll let you know. You can go pick it up because they do take, bring in some world-class products. So if it's available, they'll get it.
Absolutely.
All right, everyone, there it is, American Fireworks. So if you want to get in this display business as a worker and a helper, keep, if you live near Hudson, Ohio, come to one of the trainings. We'll announce some of them as we get closer. Hi everyone, I'm moving along. Thanks, Sabrina.
Thank you.
Everyone, you're here to play a little cards. I'm here at the Hills Fireworks booth. Just having some fun. Let's check it out. They had a little where you can play some poker. Look over here, they have where you can play blackjack. Fun prizes.
Yeah.
That's gold. Here. I did a tour of their store. They're one of my advertisers on PyroTalk.com. I want you to check their booth out while I'm here. You may recognize some of the brands when you see my video. The nice thing about this kind of store is it's a multi-brand store. Come in, kind of get the best from a lot of companies. We're here at the last day of the convention. I'm just trying to catch as much as I can. Hills Fire. Oh, look at this nice carpet.
Well, yes, ma'am.
Very nice. All right. And we got a slot machine. Okay, everyone, that's it. Hell's Fireworks. Everyone, Dave, we're still at the NFA 2019. We're here with Aaron and the Starfire system. Something new coming out we want to show you. Take a look. Modules are now wireless. Aaron is here from the company. He has a little demo program. He's going to explain his new creation to us.
All right.
Tell us what you got, Aaron.
All right. Well, these are prototypes, but they should be released by the end of the year. We have our wireless bridge. So our wireless bridge, what we're going to call air bridge most likely, is going to end up being a replacement for all your long trunk lines. So your trunk lines that usually go from your controller out into the field, or maybe if you're shooting on water out to a barge or a raft, are going to be replaced with a wireless radio. So the wireless radio is going to be connected to the controller using the same wire that you've always connected your modules to. And then what we have is we have a quick demo here. Half of our modules here on the table are connected via wire, right, like you always have. Half of our modules have a wireless receiver that ends up controlling these. So we're just going to do a quick demo. We're going to arm our system. Of course, that charges up the capacitors in the modules. And then we are simply going to fire just a little test script to show you the timing is absolutely perfect between the wired and wireless.
Pretty good. We'll get a little close-up right here.
Actually, the one to show the close-up of is probably this one over here, because ultimately the antenna is going to be mounted on the front. Okay. So this is more of a representation of what the final product is going to look like. You know, it's going to have just a small antenna. Mm-hmm. This gives you the ability to put your radio in the best spot for it to be a radio. Mm-hmm. Most firing systems, they end up having the radio in the module. And the module is where you end up hooking all your fireworks to. So, of course, you place that next to the rack, maybe behind the rack, wherever it's most convenient to be able to connect the fireworks. And your secondary thought is where the radio needs to go. Well, with this, because the radio is separate, it allows you to have the radio in the best place for the radio to be a radio, in the best place to communicate. This way, you're going to be able to communicate reliably. It's also running on 900 megahertz. So, and 900 megahertz is a spectrum that has a lot less traffic on it, because your cell phone uses 2.4 gigahertz for wireless, you know, Wi-Fi hotspots and things like that.
Yeah.
And so by being in the 900 megahertz spectrum, you can have 10 times the power that gets the signal there a lot more reliably. And it also is able to go a lot further, and it's able to go and actually penetrate through walls and buildings and with the lower frequency that the higher frequencies get blocked.
You know, I heard that once, where the higher the frequency, the less penetration it has with like solid objects.
And that's absolutely true. Yeah. Very, very low frequencies tend to go through things very well, be it buildings, racks, walls, bushes, trees. As you go up in frequency, you get to the point where literally a sheet of paper is enough to greatly reduce the amount of signal that passes through something. So by going with the lower frequency, we're actually able to communicate much more reliably, both by having 10 times the power, which is just your brute force way of doing it, but also picking a frequency that is much better for the environments we're in to be able to communicate reliably, either in a stadium, in from building top to building top, bridges, all these metal structures that will very quickly absorb the much higher frequencies. This frequency is able to go and kind of wrap around them and reflect off of them and be able to get to the destination very easily.
Okay. Is there flexibility with the wire, how long this could be here?
Well, you could end up, absolutely. I mean, if you had, for example, a circumstance where you were controlling this in a stadium, you could run this wire 1,000 feet all the way up to the top of a building if you wanted to.
Or you could run it,
you know, wherever you needed to if there was a way that you had to get the radio a long way from the controller. So obviously the goal is to get rid of the really long wire run. So normally this would probably be 10 or 15 feet away, but if you had a circumstance where you had to get the radio like over a ridge and you were shooting like in a little valley or behind, you know, a ridge line, you can bring the radio up on top of the ridge. So again, you can have very reliable communication when the two radios can see each other.
I'm thinking back of my days of working on a barge in that little duck blind.
Yeah.
With the wooden roof, would be like to mount it up there.
Well, it could be mounted.
Bring the wire down here.
It could be mounted up there.
Or
for an example, if you were on a barge, like a typical barge that would be used for grain or coal, those are actually, the floor of those is way down, and you're surrounded by steel walls.
Yeah.
And if you wanted to shoot from that with nobody on the barge, now you could put your radio on top of the steel wall, have your fireworks set up down below, and then you can still control it from shore or from another boat, so you can get everybody back and away and off of that particular barge.
Great. All right. Well, I think you explained it pretty well, and I wanted to catch you while I was here.
Yep.
And best of luck with the system.
Yes, thanks for stopping.
I hear from people that have it, and when I go out and do video, I see it out there from time to time.
Oh yeah, well this year it shot the grand public display at the PGI.
Yeah.
240 modules approximately, and yeah, it shot everything perfectly. So it's a system that we've been very, very proud to bring to the industry to enable people to shoot as big of a show as they ever want to shoot at a more affordable price.
It's nice to have those choices.
Yep.
All right, my man, take care.